Okay, let's render the Julia fractal. Okay, so first of all, what is the Julia fractal? You almost certainly know this. Boy, you've seen this before. It's something like this. And it turns out that our image won't be quite as pretty, but it will be a start, and it will show you that you can actually get going with some pretty well, you can get going with only a couple dozen lines of code, and you can create some really wonderful art. So, cargo new, and we'll create a project. Let's call it Julian, and I'll open it up. It won't do very much. It runs. Prints out hello world. So inside the dependencies, we want a couple. I want image for being able to render images. And I think at this point we are at 0.23, or let's put one and see what it does. It complains, or 0.24. I think we want in algebra. And I think it's 32, and that'll be it in terms of dependencies. Go into the source directory and let's bring a couple of things into local scope. The first thing that I'll do is create a image, and then I want two types. One is an image buffer, which is essentially sort of a memory scratch space. It's a decompressed image buffer or some segment of memory that represents pixels, and then I also need in algebra. I'm going to pull in two parts of this, the complex number type, as well as a trait normed, which provides the function or the method for doing some of the manipulations. So, the first thing to note is, actually, let's create a black image because it's sort of the hello world. I'll get rid of the thing on the left. Let's say let width as 800, and let height is 600, and then scale of X is going to be, well, let's just image the width is the word divided by width as an F64, let's say. It's always really complicated when you are trying to type and talk and also read, because I'm sort of reading my cheat sheet at the top, off to the side here as well. Hopefully you'll forgive me for not doing this off the top of my head. And I probably want to make this immutable image as my image buffer, and I want to create it such and such height and width. Now I have essentially a blank image, and inside here for every image, for every pixel, so X and Y are coordinates inside this buffer, and the pixel is the pixel data. I can assign to that pixel, it's a reference actually, to the to some RGB value. And this is the type that I brought up from the top. And let's create something that's grayscale to start with. I will just 100, 100, 100. This is out of 255 because it's these are U8 values, and then I can actually save image, save, and we'll just call this julia.png. And this should be a very highly compressible image because every pixel is exactly the same. But if I run my program now, I then go and compile and we are compiling about 400,000 things. Now that is normal in the Rust world because we're actually getting a lot of complexity for free. It turns out that image manipulation is difficult and mathematically intensive. And so I can see here, we've got a PNG crate. We have, I've got one of the ones that I thought was, we've got Rayon for enabling parallelism. So, I need to, won't worry about the in algebra so much. I trait bound I32 is not satisfied. What I can do, so what it's saying is this is the wrong type of pixels. These here are, Rust is treating the floating, it's treating the it's treating these literals as I32s instead of U8s, which isn't helpful. And now it's saying, giving me a bunch of warnings that I'm not using X and Y and all the rest of it. But if I open up the directory, I should see a gray image. In fact, that's what I do see. So hooray, we can render a completely gray image. So that's that. Well done, us. I now want to update it and create some sort of Julia function, which will take a pixel coordinate. The mathematics I'm going to muck up, but I'm going to give it a go anyway. What we're attempting to do is the render is in the complex plane, or it's, so we can't, if you go and look at, what we're going to do is search in a space of complex numbers and sort of create a visualization for what those, what happens there. And when, I'll just type this in. And so X and Y relate to the pixel coordinate that we're going to send in, and then we search in like the complex plane for this. Let's see if I can flesh this out a little bit. We create a Z variable. So we've got X, Y, and Z. And Z is itself a complex number made up of X and Y, which then we sort of manipulate some way and combine with the C parameter. This C complex number will see, we will encounter originally. It's kind of the section of the of this complex plane where the Julia set kind of resides between like negative infinity and infinity. Very, very close to the origin is this space where you have, I think it's a strange attractor, or there is some kind of weirdness mathematically, which means that this iterative function that we're calling on it ends up being quite interesting. We're going to iterate through, again, if you're a mathematician, I apologize for completely getting this wrong. And and I very much appreciate, I really want to get your explanation for how this works. So what we're going to do is, if we call this norm method, which is shorthand for I don't remember, but it is the, so it's in this complex complex number made up of the pixel coordinates of the location that we are currently inspecting. And we then see if it has broken out, So it's above 2. That means it's interesting. And then we're going to return I as a U8. Otherwise, we return a black pixel. We need to update. So the whole reason why this works is that we update the complex plane as we're going and test whether or not we have reached 255, which is white in our render. Okay, so now for every pixel, we apply the Julia function. Or at least because we want to worry about our aspect ratios, we've got the scale X and scale Y. We can actually leave those out for the moment and let's see if we still get an image that we're unhappy with. And then so we want to so we've got our, actually, no, we'll leave them in. That way it's going to work. I keep trying to go off script. Like, I've just noticed, for example, that we start with Y instead of X here. And I'm going to see if that still works. Because I know that this ends up looking really nice. But I'm a bit confused now. So anyway, we apply the scaling ratio because we want to ensure that the image looks nice in the aspect ratio that we've created. So we've created a 4 by 3 aspect ratio. And let's get on with creating this complex number. So in C, and we'll start, we can choose anywhere within the plane. It's a fractal, so it turns out that as you zoom in by making these coordinates here smaller, this is the C that we are sort of interested in. As they get smaller and smaller, we begin to see exactly the same pattern in different places. Now, instead of just returning a gray value, we are going to return a different color at each pixel, depending on CX and CY. Julia should now change if we run this. And complex is not found. Now we need to bring this back in. Oh, okay. I've done something wrong. Another mistake. Hopefully this is just suspenseful and you are waiting for the big, amazing render. Now this won't be amazing and colorful and beautiful, but it is something. Now this is the fake way of doing it. What we might want to do is go and look deeper. I want to try and experiment with what happens if I use those two. Oh, wait. CX, and I want Y here, scale X, and Y. I think my notes were actually wrong. I'm hoping they were wrong. So Julia is now re-rendered. Oh, but it's big again. I need to... So now we are sideways, which is actually what we would normally think of when we think of the Julia set. Now let's go and change the parameters. So let's go for closer to zero, and we'll halve them. So I'll go to, what's half of one? It's sure five, isn't it? I'm probably going to get that wrong. Hopefully there'll be something interesting there. So the whole point of like going and searching through all of the space is that eventually, oh gosh, we didn't get something interesting there. We got mush. Is that hopefully you find that something, and maybe I'll adjust this one. And you need to tinker very, very slowly. So there are a couple of ways to extend this project. One of them is to create a small application that enables you to tweak the parameters of where we are in the search space. The other one is to find some way to colorize the output. So all you get is you get a single pixel value, like an intensity, at every pixel location. So that's a single value, a grayscale value. It's up to you as essentially the artist to decide some framework for being able to add color for some specific reason. This is a different part of the search space, and we get a much different image. It's kind of interesting. We kind of had with like a much more of a cloud effect, which I didn't expect at all. So that is rendering Julia or the Julia set. And I hope that you have had lots and lots of fun watching me make annoying mistakes. And I will see you again on stream, hopefully. As soon as I get another chance to find some other creative coding project or something else similar. So with that, I bid you adieu, and I will see you later. Bye.